Family, welcome to Sherry's Crafting. If you have not subscribed, please do so. Please remember, like, share, comment. Let me know if you like it. Okay, guys, this in here is going to be a lot easier quilt. You don't have to cut the squares, so you might like this one better. Okay, I have 2 yards of the solid gray. And I have a little bit more, because she said she gave me a little bit more of the gray with the white polka dots. And what you're going to do is you're going to need some safety pins is what I'm going to use. You can use straight stick pins, and you need your gray thread. You're going to need your scissors. And you're going to need your sewing machine. Alright, what you're going to do is you're going to take your fabric. You're going to take and open them up. And open this one. And it does not matter which way you do the gray. But I want my polka dot to be my front and the gray to be my back. And what you're going to do is you're going to take one corner. Let me set you guys down here so you can see what I'm doing. Sorry. You're going to take one corner and put over here. And I'm just opening it up so I can basically get it even. Both pieces. And I don't have a table big enough, so let me turn. Let me fold the gray over so I can switch it. This one as long as I can get it. All right. This is where sometimes if you have 2 people, if you don't have a table big enough like I don't, you can have someone hold the end while you get it even. Now I do this one. I asked for 2 yards of each. I got just probably 2 inches more. And I'm going to fold it in half, all 4 pieces. Do not worry that you do have any extra down here, because on my white, guys, y'all, I have been cleaning lint from my dryer vent from the previous blanket, and I got to sneezing so bad. So if I get to sneezing, I'm sorry. All right, this is the part that I was telling you, fold it in half, okay? From one end down to the other, fold it over. Now, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take where you have it in half. You're going to lay it down. Remove this so you guys can see what I'm doing. And make sure it's recording. All right. Put this over on this side of my table so I can see. Hold on, guys. Let me scoot y'all back a hair so I can get this fabric down. All right. Now, make sure that you do have your fabric folded and it's even, because if not, you're going to end up with some short. Make sure this is even. What you're going to do, you're going to fold that in half. And right here is where, on the folded edge, is where I want to take some safety pins. Or if you have any other kind of pins you want, just make sure you go through all four pieces, where your sewing machine is not going to be touching this. And I just got this kind of, just to kind of hold it so it won't move while I'm sewing it. Okay, put one here. And I'm gonna put one down here. Slide my fabric over. Now, some people like to iron it. I'm not, because I kind of know how this fabric does. But you can if you want. But I don't want to. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause this and I'm going to get my sewing machine. We're going to sew. I'm going to take this back loose. It's not even. Make sure. Yeah, it's in there. Okay. I'm going to come back and I'm going to show y'all. We're going to sew this fold in half. We're going to sew all the way down. Okay? All the way down. And I'll show you the next step. So I'll be right back and show you what we do, because I'll have my sewing machine up here and show y'all. Okay, family. Y'all remember we put their safety pins in. Now, all we're gonna do is we're gonna come here, find our 1 inch right there. I'm going to stitch, back stitch, and go all the way down. I do warn you, this video may be long. Keep it going. Thank you. always backstitch, guys. After I stitch a few in the beginning and at the end. Now, let me show you what you do here. Okay. I'm going to take these pins out. That I put in the first time. And you don't have to use them again. Unless you think your fabric will move on you. Okay. See how we have gotten a little 1-inch pleat here? All you're going to do is take your scissors, go in between both fabrics, and you're going to split it. Because what's going to happen is you're going to make your rag this way. Up here. Let me start down on this end. And you just cut all the way down till you get to the end. And don't worry if you think, oh my goodness, this is hard. It's not. Just make sure you got your scissors in between. And if you want to lay it down on a table and cut down that seam, you can. But I pretty much can get my scissors in here and do it this way. After you get this cut, I'll show you what you do next. That way you don't have all the squares to be cutting out. You don't have to put the batting because this is pretty heavy like it is. And do not pre-wash the fabric. You do it after you get through. Now, see? We have got our rag part. Don't worry if you got a little bit more of the polka dotted white. Don't worry about that because it's going to really look cool, guys. I'm telling you. Okay, we have got that part. Now, here, you can see, when you open it up, you have got the first part of your rag quilt, because you're going to come back and you're going to cut it. All right, now, here is what I want to do. I'm going to take, since I have mine open, I'm going to take the gray, put that over there. Ooh, my extra. Because this one's going to be really big. Let me set my sewing machine down here. Now, since y'all know, we have got our first middle done, all you're going to do is you're going to take it and open it up, spread it out. Got my glass there. Get your pleat there. And what you're going to do is you're going to take this fabric. And you're going to fold it over where your stitch here is. Can y'all see this stitch? Let's see. That's the stitch we sewed, okay? I grabbed one end. We are folding it in. We're gonna go over about a half an inch because the gray fabric is longer, okay? And even it out. Now, if you want to, you can take your safety pins and pin through all four fabrics. Make sure you always have what's going to be showing. That's going to be your top, the ragged part that you want the top. Shows on the top, because if you turn it the other way and got the gray showing, you know you got it the wrong way. You're always going to be sewing your polka dotted or your pattern, whichever way you want. And I'm just sticking these here so kind of help keep this together. I'm not going to have to put one down there. Now we're getting the sewing machine back up. There goes that teal thread. And we're going to sew here on the fold, half an inch in, all the way down this way. Then we're going to cut this. So let's get that going. So you guys see that I am doing it this way. Okie dokie. Okay. Grab my folded fabric. Now, well, 1 inch, get that there where I want it, and sew it down, back stitch, and pick it on that 1 inch. Cut it. Same way we did the first one. Always check your fabric. Make sure you're still at that 1 inch. Because if it gets off a little bit, you can adjust it back. So don't worry. And see if y'all like this one better. I used to just do mine with the strips, and I didn't go the other way where it would be, you know, not squares, just strips. And if you like it that way, you can do it that way. Now, we're doing the same thing where we just sewed. We're going to cut this in half, the same way. And go all the way down. Which this one, I may do it in the stripes instead of the squares. Because I like that better. Okay. See? I split it all the way down. That's the part we're going to be ragging. Now, let me take my pins out. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're just flipping it around. See, we have got two. I don't know where this string come from. Oh, my thread that fell on the floor. See, we've got one and two. Now, what we're gonna do is the two that we've already done, we're moving those over here. We're gonna find our center here. Okay, now we're going to fold this half in, and remember our gray is a little bit shorter, so make sure you go over and line it up where it goes over, so that way it will be even. Okay. Wow, that's really, okay. Really, really long on this side. And what we do, get your wrinkles out. Make sure it's even. Because if it's not, you're going to have puckers. And you don't want any puckers. Now, make sure it is even. I had that part down there twisted, so make sure I get this down here where it's straight. Now I'm going to come in, put safety pin. All the way through. I'm just gonna put two. Cause I can pretty much keep it straight. All right, now we're going back to the sewing machine. Remember, always have your fabric showing on the sewing machine that you're going to use for your top. Always. Now, find my inch. Line it up. And sew. Backstitch. And we're basically doing the same thing. I'm doing the other side. Same way. Backstitch. Thread. Now we're going to cut that one. The same way. Take your pins out. It's a piece of fabric that's sitting there. I thought, oh my god, I had a spider drop down. Y'all hear me holler. Okay, open it up. Whoops, I'm gonna get my pins out. Get my safety pins out. My nose is itching. Plus, I cleaned it. I dusted in there. I think a dog hair. Ugh. Alright. So, we have got two three done. Okay. Now, here is what I want to do. On my ends, I want to take because I'm making the strips, I'm not going to do the squares. All right, I'm going to do one close here to the end. Fold this in half. Well, I don't like that. I'm just gonna leave it like that and have the four pleats. All right. Now, here is what you do next, okay? And here's how I do mine. I take and I fold it where my first rag is gonna be. I take my scissors and I start ragging, snipping. And what I like to do is I separate it in half where that way I don't cut my stitches. Because if you cut that stitch, you're going to go back and sew it. So be careful. And you just snip this all the way. Then we're going to sew 1/2 inch all the way around our blanket. And then we're going to rag it around the edges. So everywhere where you see where you took and sewed your strip, you're going to go back and you're going to clip it. And I'm not doing the squares. You can fold it the other way and get the squares if you want. And you see, there's no batting, but this quilt is heavy. So you guys get to see me. Now this is where the time comes in, okay? I mean, if you wanna sit in front of a TV or have the radio going, what you do, make time pass. My fingers has got a blister from the other blanket from snipping. And you can use what they call the rag scissors. They're square and it's where you use your hand and not like the regular scissors. Those do work. I just don't have any. I looked in Walmart. Walmart didn't have any. They had one pair that was really expensive. And I'm like, nah. I'm using my scissors. Does just as good. Alright guys, this will probably be my last DIY for a while. As y'all know, I start my chemo tomorrow. And I have some changes and I've got to be there at 8 in the morning. So, I don't know what the changes are. My husband took the phone call. I tried calling back, but she had an emergency, so I'm like, So we will see what they want. Hopefully, there's some good news, I'm hoping. But we will see. So guys, if y'all don't see a video, y'all know it's because I'm doing my chemo. Just keep those prayers coming. Alright, I have got this whole row here done. Now, I'm going to grab another row. And we're snipping it too. Snip, snip, snip. Do not cut your stitches. I can pretty much see the gray thread. So, not worried about this one. But this quilt here is a little bit faster. So, if y'all want to try something quick, this one's quicker. Because on the other video, guys, I'm gonna tell you, I thought it was recording and it was not recording. Okay. And it took me 2 days to do that one quilt. So that's between measuring and cutting out the 10 by 10 squares and cutting the felt a 5x5 or a 7x7, I think. So, I mean, yeah, it does take time cutting. Alright, after I get all these cut, I am going to sew all the way around the blanket. An inch in all the way around. And then we're gonna take our scissors and we're gonna cut just like this here around the edges. So, you guys know what I'm doing. I think these scissors are getting dull. And they are. And you can make your little rag strips here, the little slices, any size you want, but do not go above an inch. So make sure you cut it under an inch on your little slices. Because the smaller your slice, the more it will rag when you wash it. Alright, and I get this here done. Then we'll sew around. And I'll show y'all how I'm going to cut this one end off. because it does have the white showing on that. And any extra that is long on the ends, I'm going to snip that off. Alright, I have got it all cut, and I'm making the strips, not the squares. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab my sewing machine, and I'll show y'all what we're doing next. My bobbin is out. No. Show y'all what we're doing. We're just gonna sew all the way around the edges. And I'm not worried about the extra that's coming off. I'm going to come in from where my fat, because I know my grate down on this end is bigger. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in where an inch is, and I'm going to start sewing around my blanket. And you do not have to have a fold. Trying to get this done fast for you guys. Now you can take and just turn your, you know, hold your foot up and turn it around. I don't want to do that because I am going to have to clip off over here where that extra fabric part is. And I want to make sure that when I clip that off, I'm not cutting my thread. So it won't, you know, because it can come loose if you do. And you don't want your corners coming loose. Now, we're getting to our ruffle. And some people like to just lay it down. Me, I just go over it. Because no matter what, that one little part is still going to, you're going to have to cut it, no matter what. And I'll show you what I mean. But you can do it however way you want. It's up to you. Get your blanket. I'm just trying to give you an idea. And this one here will be bigger. You're not making the squares. This one will be like a twin. Now I'm going to show you. Do y'all see all the extra hair? That's the reason I said make sure you go over, because we're going to cut that off. Now, let's see, how many sides have I gotten? I need to cut that one. All right. Other end here so we can see where I can start cutting this off. All right, let me show you. Down here on this end here, see how the polka dotted fabric is longer. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to cut that down even with my gray. I'm not worried if it's a little longer, just a little, because we can cut that off after we get through. Pretty much stay with those polka dots. All right. And we'll come back and cut those, the white part off. So let's get our sewing machine back. Get our thread right. Right, get my 1 inch. All right. Stitch, back stitch. Then we're going to trim our excess off and cut our little slits and go stick it in the washer. See, that one moved on me. That one moved. Alright. and cut the thread. Okay, I got one more side here I got to do. Oh, I thought I was on three. One more side. So let's get this done. And I'll see how much I gotta go over, because I gotta cut. Try to keep this straight. Really? Backstitch. Now, all you're gonna do hit the sewing machine off. Ouch. Because you're basically done with the sewing machine. Now, all you're gonna do. Is where this white part here is, I'm gonna come and start cutting it off. I'm just going straight. All the way down on that one side, because I don't want that little remnant part. All the way down. Let me move this where I can. Cut this off. I mean, you could do it, you know, before you start your sewing. But always wait till the end. And then cut it up. All the way down. All right. Now, down on the end where it's the gray fabric is longer on this end, all you're gonna do is trim it to where it's the same as your polka dotted fabric. You're just trimming away the extra so we can start cutting the rag part around our quilt. I was going to use my rotary cutter, but I could not find my little wrench so I could change the blade. So I said, well, I just use my scissors. Cut the extra off. I know this is a long video. I'm sorry. But guys, you know, hey, somebody wants to make one. You got step by step. Step by step. Now, this little bit, I'm not worried. Well, I already got that one. Okay. Now, here is where the fun comes in. Take your quilt around your corners, and you're going to start ragging your quilt. Just like we did the middle part. Don't cut your edges where you sewed, or you will be going back and getting around that sewing machine. I can't sleep, so I'm not going out. Just come in here. Do my quilt. I think my sewing machine, all this fabric cutting and threads, it's getting to me. After I get this done, guys, I'm going to stick it in the wash, but I will show you just a second that we're making the strip rags and not the squares. And yes, this one is bigger. know y'all saying, girl, you need some music on or talking or something. I don't want to use any music. I wind up getting a copy strike. So. Keep going. I gotta get my shower. Get that done. So I can be there at 8 o'clock. My husband was in there rubbing his nose. He's like, what in the world? He kept sneezing. I told him, I says, I don't know. I mean, is it dust from when I was in there cleaning or dog hair? Because I was trying to get everything dusted and cleaned. So when I don't feel like doing it, it's not. Because the dogs are outside in the garage now. Because it's cool out there at night now. It's not too hot. And they got a fan going. So they're fine. And plenty of water. Guys, I'm telling you, cutting the little strips. I think this is the this is the part where it takes so long. I hope this is the only side I got left. Nope. One more side. Since I've been cutting this, I can pretty much see how much I gotta cut. Without cutting the stitches there. This is the last side. Thank God. Goes to get in the washer. And then the dryer. And we will see what this one looks like. Now this one will fit on a twin bed, guys. My husband was like, I can't use that other one. I want my whole body covered up. I said, it ain't for you. And he's like, why not? think the gray and white is cute. Almost there, guys. Now, this is what it looks like before I go stick it in the washer, okay? Can y'all see? Can y'all see? I know it's twisted because I'm not tall enough. And then there's another one down here. You see? Now, I'm going to stick this in the wash and the dryer and show y'all. This is just the strips. And if you want more, you can fold it in half and add more strips, you know, sew it. But this one is going to be big enough for a twin. So let me know, guys, if you like it. I will be back and post what it looks like out of the dryer.